Welcome, 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 my brothers and sisters. It's the second or the first Sunday after Resurrection Sunday. And we are celebrating the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ from the grave. Come back with power, with might, and triumphantly. And it's in a similar way that we can celebrate the coming back of our Lord. We can celebrate also the fact that we can rebound from any of our life situations that we experience in our journey. Whether it is sickness, whether it is financial situation, it's a general thing with the economy and COVID virus. We know that through the power of Jesus Christ, as a people, we can rebound. We can regain our strength. We can regain our focus, and we can move forward. So welcome in that spirit, a rebounding spirit today. And we are declaring that in the name of Jesus, we can rebound, and we are rebounding. I want to welcome you, both those that are listening in the Barrytown congregation, the Mount Zion congregation, and by extension, our Formites brothers and sisters in their congregation that they are sharing with us this morning. So we bless God for this day that the Lord has made, and we can rejoice and be glad in it. It is called the Rebounding Sunday, the Sunday that we rebound, as Jesus rebound from his death and come back to his resurrection power. We too, brothers and sisters, can come back in the name of Jesus Christ. We commence with a song that is made popular by Shirley Caesar and is sung by one BJ Vassasar. He can do it again.
Yeah.
Yes, brothers and sisters. He will do it again. You may not know how, but he will do it again. Hallelujah. Let us look to the Lord. Father, we celebrate your goodness, your power. We celebrate the resurrection power that is in your Son, Jesus Christ. And that power that can raise us from any situation, any problem that we find ourselves in. O God Almighty, we thank you for your healing power. Thank you for your divine providence that you continue to open doors for us, even when it seems as if there is no way out. That you supply our needs, you take care of our financial, domestic, spiritual, physical needs. And oh God, you have not let up in all that we go through. You have been there. Great is your faithfulness, oh God. From morning by morning, new mercies we see, and all that we have needed, your hands have provided. Great is your faithfulness to us, O God. As we look to you, we continue to pray, Lord Jesus, for the sick, for the needy, for the helpless, those in our pastoral charge that are not well, those who are homebound. You know them, O God, by names. You know them by number. We bring them to you, Lord. We bring them to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Morrises, we bring Sister Fender. Oh God, we bring at this time, we bring Sister Campbell, Sister G. Darnett. We bring, oh God Almighty, Sister Crooks to you, Lord. We bring all of these persons to you right now, Lord. We commit them into your hands. We speak to their healing, to their deliverance. Lord, we pray for those overseas in the name of Jesus, in the States, in Canada, in Europe, in Scotland, Lord Jesus, in Brazil, in the Caribbean, the Bahamas, St. Kitts, Lord, Aruba. We pray for all the hurting people, for our family members, those who are tested and challenged, those who are physically hurting. Lord, we ask you right now that you will raise them up, lift up their standard. We pray for our church, for the synod that will go through this week. We pray, O God Almighty, that you will guide us. May you lead us in the pathway of righteousness, and may your Holy Spirit, Lord, work in our lives to bring us healing. Bless us today as we gather. In Christ's name we pray. And may you bring us healing and deliverance. In Christ's name we pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We may not know how. We may not know when, but he will do it again. At this time, brothers and sisters, we are going to be looking to a portion of God's word from Isaiah chapter 40. And we are going to read verse 28 to 31. Isaiah is writing and he says, "Have you not known? Have you not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Father, open our eyes to your word today and bring us healing and deliverance through its inspiration. In Christ's name we pray. Hallelujah. Rebounding through resurrection power, brothers and sisters. One cannot understand what it means to rebound if you do not understand what it means to suffer setbacks. And when we talk about setbacks, we are talking about having experiences which create reversal in our lives, or check our progress, hinders us from moving forward, delay us from moving in the direction that we want to in our endeavors. Setbacks come in varied forms. They can come in your professional life, in your career, in your financial life, in your physical life, in your educational life, in your spiritual journey. And if you are not careful, these setbacks sometimes can floor you in such a way that if you are not careful, you feel like there is no way that you can come back from these setbacks. And this is the end of you. This is the end of the road for you, or the end of the journey for you, that it will allow you to feel. And even if we never experienced setbacks in our lives before, COVID virus has given us good lessons as to what it means to experience real setbacks, brothers and sisters. We have experienced setbacks in our schools from kindergarten to university, where our children cannot study. They cannot sit exams, right? We have experienced setbacks in the health sector, where it is overwhelmed to the extent that people are afraid to go to the hospital. We have experienced setbacks in our tourist industry. From I was a boy, it's the first I've seen such a lull, even in the cruise ship industry. We have experienced setback in the private sector, in the banking sector, in our social activities, in our travel arrangements and vacational arrangements. We are restricted in our movements, in our church activities, in our worship services, things which we used to see as commonplace and take for granted, brothers and sisters, we are now told that you cannot do those things. So we are given real lessons in setbacks and what it means to experience setbacks in our lives, setbacks in our nation, and setbacks in our families. Everyone is affected in these setbacks. The sick, the healthy, the old, the good, the bad, the young, the rich, the poor, the Christians and non-Christians alike, or the black, the white, the famous, the not so famous, oh brothers and sisters. But is there hope? Yes, there is hope. Because Jesus himself experienced what would have been and what would have seen as being one of the greatest setbacks in his mission. Oh yes, they took him They crucified him. They buried him. They placed him in a tomb. They locked him down. Many thought that by locking him into a tomb, killing him up on Friday, and locking him into a tomb, that was the end of his ministry, end of all that he believed, end of all that he professed to be. But he used it to his advantage in allowing God the Father to demonstrate through him the power of the resurrection. Brothers and sisters, that on the third day he came back. The enemies that thought it was the end of him, he rebounded before their very eyes by coming back from the grave. He rebounded with power. As the songwriter says, up from the grave he arose with a mighty triumph over his foes. He arose a victor from the last domain, and from the dark domain, and he lives forever with the saints to reign. He arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. What it means to rebound, brothers and sisters, to rebound is to come back after a negative impact, or to bounce back from after having experienced some setbacks or tragedies. In order to rebound effectively, we have to know who we are, brothers and sisters. We have to know who we are and how to treat with our setbacks if we are going to come back. When you experience your setbacks, it is understanding how we relate to those setbacks that will allow us to be victorious and allow us to come back. If we treat the setbacks as victors over us, our brothers and sisters, in a way where we feel that, oh, this is the end of it, and give up, throwing your hands in the air, then of course that is going to be the end of it for you. I believe that Paul speaks to this kind of having some form of setback in the Bible when he says in 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 7 to verse 14, Paul says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. For we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then death work in us, but life in you. We, having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believe, and therefore have I spoken. We also believe, and therefore speak, knowing that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise us also by Jesus, and shall present us with you. In other words, Paul is saying that we have to understand, brothers and sisters, what it means to be cast down, to experience setback, and how we relate to it. So he says, we have this treasure in earthen vessel. In other words, it is telling us that we are vessels of clay. And as vessels of clay, we are human. We have limitations. We are not beyond challenges. We are not beyond testings. We are vessels of clay. We are breakable. We are vulnerable. Yet God chooses to put precious gifts in us. Intrinsic gifts. Gifts of intrinsic value in us. So we can fail and we can fall, but brothers and we can pick up a crack along the way, but we can rebound in the name of Jesus Christ. In verse 8 it says, we have to learn how through Christ to experience trouble on every side, yet not distress. Do not allow it to let you suffer misery, agony. For agony, brothers and sisters, and distress, these things are temporary. How to be troubled, but do not despair. We have to learn how to be troubled. but not to be despaired. To despair is to be completely lose hope. Yes, and we cannot lose hope completely, because the Bible says, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. How to be persecuted, but not to feel forsaken and abandoned. Because all of us who are Christians, we are vessels of clay. So we are not beyond persecution. We are not beyond sickness. We are not beyond disparate situations, but we cannot give up hope. Amen. How to be persecuted, but not to feel forsaken or abandoned. Cast down, but not destroyed. There is still life in us. That's what Paul is saying. And verse 10, he went on and he says, always bearing about in our body the same power that was in the dying Christ manifest in us. But it is two ways, brothers and sisters. We bear the mark of Christ's suffering, for if we suffer with him, we shall reign with him. We know the power of his suffering and of his, but we also know the power of his resurrection. And in verse 14, he said, knowing that the same spirit which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise us also by Jesus. Right? So the same spirit, although we bear the streak and the mark of his suffering in us, because we are followers of Christ, and if he suffers, if suffered, we can suffer too. But we, brothers and sisters, also bear the mark of the power of his resurrection in us. So the same power that raised up Christ from the dead, dwelling us, shall also quicken our mortal body. That same power that raised up the dying Christ, that same power can cause us to rebound and overcome from whatever sickness and difficulties and situation, dead situations that we experience in our life. It is the same spirit power that will cause us to rebound. Through the same power that raised up Christ, we can rebound through that life-giving, resurrection, life-changing power. We are suffering setbacks, but you can rebound in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. If we go back to our text, brothers and sisters, we just want to end by sharing a few principles as to what it means, how do we rebound, all right, when we are going through our setbacks. So how we rebound from our situation. And I think that the text we read earlier speaks to it. Yeah, speaks to it. We have to understand first who God is and the role he plays in helping us in rebounding in our lives. If we do not understand first who God is, then we cannot rebound. But if we go with doubt as to who God is when we are faced with our situation, then we are going to lose hope. Yes. A little sickness come and we lose hope. A little problem come and we give up. Little discouragement and we step down. But brothers and sisters, we understand who God is in our journey. We're not going to give up hope. Hear what the Bible tells us in verse 28. It says, hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the end of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. So one, we have to understand, brothers and sisters, that God is everlasting, is from generation to generation. Yes, have you not known, have you not heard, that the everlasting God is an everlasting God. He spans generation. He has seen it. He has seen it all. He is creator and Lord of the end of the earth. Yes, I said, as you not heard, have you not known that everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth? Yes. So he makes everything upon the earth. Creator from one end to the other. Creator of the end of the earth. He faint not, neither is he weary. He sees everything. He's not weary. He fainted not, neither is weary. In other words, you cannot call upon him and he lost his strength, his energy. right to respond. He fainted not, he is not weary. There is no searching of his understanding. In other words, his understanding is beyond boundaries. He understands our suffering. He cares and he understands whatever we go through. So we rebound when we understand who God is, understand his enormity, understand that he's ancient of days, understand that he's from generation to generation, that kings come and kingdoms fall, but God never fails. Oh, hallelujah. That is from generation to generation, years in, years out. He's the same yesterday, today, forever. God, there are two immutable things about God. One, he's unchangeable. And two, he cannot lie. And he stands with us from generation to generation. Secondly, brothers and sisters, not only do we need to understand who God is and the role he and function he plays within our lives, but we cannot stand in our strength, but in God's strength. And in times like these, you cannot rely on your natural abilities to overcome situations and to work out idiosyncrasies and difficulties in our lives. We have to stand in God's strength. Verse 29 says, he gives power to the faint, and to him that have no might, he increased strength. So he says in verse 30, even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. In other words, that if you are young and you feel that you can rely on your physical energy and physical strength, even young people will say are failing today. That's what the Bible says. Even the youth faint, and they become weary. All right? But he increases the strength of his people, giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases their strength. So we have to understand, brothers and sisters, that we cannot stand in our strength, but in God's strength. He gives power to the faint when you feel as if you are losing it, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. Brothers and sisters, yes, he increases strength. And so we have to understand that. We have to understand that God increases our strength. We cannot stand in our strength if you're going to rebound. We cannot rebound with our own ideologies and with our own physical, human, limited strength. Remember now we said we are vessels of clay, but in God's strength. And lastly, if we are going to rebound, when we are down in our setbacks, we have to learn how to wait upon God. Yes, we have to learn to wait upon God, because sometimes we want the deliverance to come like yesterday or yesteryear, but it has not come. But we have to wait. And that's why the Bible ends by saying, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. It is in waiting upon God that the rebounding power comes. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Yes, brothers and sisters, and this time when we rebound, we are not going to be, just rebound and just fall back, relapse into our situation. This time we're going to run without being weary. This time we're going to walk and not faint. Hallelujah. This time we are going to be like eagles. We are going to soar. Yes, so we have to, brothers and sisters, learn how to wait upon the Lord. Learn how to wait in our difficulties. Learn how to wait when we are in the valley. Those who wait upon God, they shall renew their strength. They shall soar with wings like eagles. When you come back, you shall run and not be weary, and you shall walk and not faint. Do not matter what you are experiencing and what you are going through. Once you trust in God, brothers and sisters, we shall rebound. I think the opening verses of the chapter 40 give comforting words. So it says, and I think that we should hold on to that. It's a comfort ye, my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortable to to Jerusalem, and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned, for she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. In other words, the problems that we came upon us and that we encountered, those problems have now, we have now been punished for those situations, or whatever phase of our lives we were going through. We have now experienced, brothers and sisters, the suffering for that season. And now is the time for resurrection power to take set in us, and for us to rebound and to come back from those period of setbacks and trials that we go through. We were persecuted, but not destroyed. We rise from our situations in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God bless you today, and the Lord keeps you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Hallelujah. Come on.
Still God in the